Hello, everyone. Welcome to Tuesday of our Holy Week devotionals. I love Tuesdays. I love this whole concept of this Holy Week. I love mentally and physically walking through the timeline and the chronology of what Jesus was doing leading up to this Friday, which was the day of the cross, which literally changed everything. So on Monday, we saw that Jesus was challenging the religious establishment physically by overthrowing the tables in the temple. And today on Tuesday, we see him challenging the religious establishment mentally by challenging their questions that they were throwing at him. You could kind of categorize this day into a couple of buckets, arguing and agriculture. This seems to be what Jesus focuses on. The arguing part, where the Pharisees, we see them trying to mentally trip up Jesus by asking him all of these weird questions. And they weren't asking for knowledge. They were asking to try to trip him up because they wanted to catch him in a lie and try to discredit him. And we see him, you know, kind of arguing with them. And it's kind of like what the world does today. The world is constantly trying to push on our faith in Jesus. And I think most folks are very genuine in their knowledge, in their, you know, thirst for knowledge and understanding. But a lot of folks are just trying to trip it up and just arguing for the sake of arguing. Our beliefs are challenged from all sides every day. And that's why I believe that this faith series that our church has been in for the last several Sundays has been so important. Because it encourages us to be able to defend our faith. In 1 Peter 3, 15 and 16, it says, "But in your heart set apart Christ as Lord, and always be prepared to give a reason for the hope that you have. But do so keeping a clear conscience, so that those who speak maliciously against your good behavior in Christ may be ashamed of their slander." We want to be able to answer and present good arguments for our faith, and that's what Jesus is doing here. But then another part that happens on Tuesday of Holy Week is a very unique passage of Scripture that's referred to as the cursed fig tree. And there's a lot of kind of debate around this passage. A lot of commentaries argue one way or the other. Now, Jesus actually cursed this fig tree yesterday on Monday, but on Tuesday is when they walk by and they notice that it is completely withered away. And the disciples recognize this and say, "Hey, Jesus, that's the one that you cursed yesterday, and now it's dead." And Jesus uses this as opportunity to make a couple of points. And so I want to draw three quick thoughts from this action that Jesus of cursing this fig tree. First one is, if you're going to have leaves, you should have some fruit. In all the works of the ministry of Jesus, this is the only miracle that was destructive. Now, if this was the only miracle of its kind, we must see that there was there's an important lesson in here. And what is that lesson? I believe that God is showing us that He doesn't approve when there is a profession of faith without reality. When there is, if I could put it this way, when there's a talk without the walk. If you're gonna have leaves like the fig tree did, you should have fruit. In other words, if you're gonna hang our flag out there that we are Christians and that we are a church that welcomes people, then we're a follower of Jesus, then we have to have this fruit to show for it. Now, many commentaries argue that it wasn't the season for figs, and there's a lot of debate there, but our faithfulness should be shown by our fruitfulness. In James chapter 2, verse 26, it says, "Faith without works is dead." The second thing that Jesus points out here is that faith can move mountains. Immediately following, after the disciples said, "Look, it's dead. Look what you did." Verse number 22 of Mark chapter 11, Jesus says, "Have faith in God." And that famous passage where he says, if you have faith and you say to this mountain, "Go throw yourself into the sea," and do not doubt in your heart, but believe what he says will happen, it will be done for you. This is what Jesus tells him. "I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you have received it and it will be yours." But the next verse is also important. "And when you stand praying, if you hold anything against anyone, forgive him, so that your Father in heaven may forgive you." You can't just pray selfish prayers and expect them to be answered on a whim. They have to be aligned with the Spirit of God. They have to further God's kingdom. They can't be selfish and things of this nature. And if you can do those things, then your prayers can be answered. And then it moves us to the third thought that Jesus shared, which was actually a little bit back in the passage where he says, I'm hungry. You know, Jesus was going from Bethany into Jerusalem back and forth, and you know, maybe he didn't stop for breakfast that morning on the way in. And so he says, I'm hungry, and he comes to this fig tree looking for food, because it says he saw it off in the distance. So he was approaching it looking for sustenance. We've got Easter Sunday coming up. The world is going to be approaching our church looking for sustenance. And can I tell you, the world is hungry for the Word. Now, Matthew records this as one event, but Mark brings out more detail, noting that it was the second day when they actually saw that the fig tree was dead. And Jesus said he was hungry, and that gives us the context clues that he was looking for figs, but he found none. The world is hungry for the Word. The world is going to be coming to church this Sunday looking for something that truly satisfies. And we can't let them come into a church that is nicely adorned and nicely appointed, but it's not anointed. We can't put the leaves out but have no fruit. In other words, we can't let folks come to a church and see a bunch of leaves but no fruit. They see a lot of smiles and a lot of music, but there's no love, there's no truth, there's no grace. So remember, this week on Tuesday, Jesus showed us, be fruitful and believe by faith that you can move mountains. Believe by faith that this Sunday lives can be changed because of the power of the cross. And remember that this week, invite someone to church with you this Sunday, because I can almost guarantee you that they are hungry for what Jesus can give them if they show up. We love you, church. Have a great week.